Hello, Heart of Mary. So about 4 weeks ago, I was really struggling with frustration and discouragement. And what I can tell you about it is that I definitely was frustrated because my spirit was very conflicted. I was feeling conflict in my spirit because of everything that I was lacking, everything that had been lost throughout this pandemic as far as my church is concerned. My spirit was conflicted and frustrated because I wasn't getting the things that I had grown to depend on. Now, understanding that the Eucharist is the source and summit of our faith, I do get that. And I'm very thankful that that has been restored with some restrictions. But I was able to pinpoint what was really happening to me, to my spirit, and it had to do with the disconnect of my parish community, and it was causing me to suffer, and my spirit was feeling it, and I was feeling desperate. I even had this mad idea when I was out for a walk, and I thought about just the fact that I can't sing right now. We're not allowed to sing in church, and just to be able to say those words doesn't even make sense to me, all because of a danger with it, I guess. But the thing is, I was so frustrated up to here. So I was desperately feeling like I was gonna change it. And I came home and I told my husband, you know what, I'm gonna drag my boombox with the microphone up to the park, and I'm gonna start singing and praising and worshiping in the park, and I hope and pray that other people who are missing singing and music and heartfelt praise to God would walk over and lift up their hands and they would join me. Well, my husband again softly reminded me that technically not singing was what we were supposed to be doing. And again, clearly that's something I can't even begin to wrap my head around. It just doesn't make sense. And you know what else doesn't make sense? It doesn't make sense that there are so many conflicting rules that have come with these last 6 months of the pandemic. One of which is I can't even let go of the fact that people are flying all over the world right now, neck to neck, and I can't even be 6 feet close to my brothers and sisters in Christ when I go to Holy Mass. So in that frustration, I found myself crying out to God, what can I do, God? How can you help me through this? I've never felt this way in my life. And God smiled down on me and wrapped his beautiful arms around me and helped me to feel his love through a beautiful priest that I stumbled upon. It was a face-to-face meeting that not only produced real peace for my heart, but also this precious father reminded me in how I should be lifting up my frustrations for the sins of the world. And I lift up sufferings anyways for the souls in purgatory, so I thought, what a grand idea. I know it, but I just needed to be reminded of it. So looking back these past months, I've really had time to reflect on those particular days that I felt extra frustrated, those particular days that the loss in my spirit was truly affecting me. And talking to that priest was only the first step to feeling better. But then the next step came in a way for me to be able to help with a beautiful prayer service that came together. And actually, again, another phone call, another person asking me to help with another prayer service. And I really saw God's beautiful hand in that, reaching down and reminding me that he had work for me to do, and that these things are truly sustaining for my spirit as well. So I guess that's the point of me sharing this story with you. Bits and pieces of precious service to God make a huge difference to how we feel in our spirits. So what is it that you can do? The options are endless. we're still limited with separation, but there are things that we can do. We just have to get creative. Also doing this, Hello Heart of Mary, is a precious gift to my spirit. To be able to connect with all of you and to be able to pray for you is so good. It feels so great. So pray for me, dear friends, and I'll pray for you. God bless you. Have a beautiful day. Bye, everyone.